But the problem is we don't plan. That's the problem. The dunya. كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَ. And I use this word, عَاجِلَ. Something that comes and passes very quick. خلاص. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. This world is nothing but a deceiving vanity that deceives. It deceives me and you. What are we running after? How many years are we going to live to meet Allah? Brothers, fathers, tell me. The saddest thing is, if someone who is 40, 60, and still they behaving like the one who is 20, 15, that makes it sad, right? Makes it so sad. Shaitan said, he said, Allah, وَلَا أُضِلَّنَّهُمْ. I will misguide them. I will mislead them. وَلَأُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ. And I will make them have desire for this world. What kind of desire? خَلَصْ. وَلَأُمَرَنَّهُمْ. I will command them. He will not, he didn't say, I will just talk to them. No, he said, I will command them. Do you believe Shaitan will command one? Command. You know what is command, isn't it? Thank you. I'm the commander, I'm in charge. You do as I say. But how can Shaitan have command over someone? That's the thing. He said, وَلَا أَمُرَنَّهُمْ وَلَا يُبَتِّكَنَّ وَلَا يُبَتِّكُنَّ آذَانَ الْأَنْعَامِ وَلَا أَمُرَنَّهُمْ فَلَيُغَيِّرُنَّ خَلَقَ اللَّهِ. Said, I will command them to slit the ears of the animals, the cattle, and I will make them change their creation. I will command them to change their creation. Is this not the situation now? Is it not the situation? MashaAllah, Allah created me. I said, no. Allah, you did not create me the way you're supposed to. You should have touched here this way a bit, but that's not how it happened. So I will teach you what you have been done. That's what it sounds like. That you made this, you did not do it nicely, perfect. I want to do it in the best way, right? The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah cursed three people. Allah cursed them. They are cursed. And one of them, Al-Mar'a Mutarajjina. The woman who dresses appear like a man. And also as well the man, the one who dresses and appears like a woman. The creation, we are changing the whole creation. Shaitan said, I will make them change their creation. It's not me, that's the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, according to Allah, he said, Shaitan said, he said, I will command them to change their creation. And Allah said, وَمَنْ يَتَّخِذِ الشَّيْطَانُ وَلِيًّا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ فَقَدْ خَسِرَ خُسْرَانًا مُبِينًا. Anyone who chooses Shaitan to be their commander, their friend, their ally, then khalas, that person is in a manifest loss. Allah said, Ya'iduhum. Shaitan will promise them, wa yumannihim, and will make them have their desire. وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ إِلَّا. Allah said, but Shaitan promises them nothing but vanity. Just a deceiving word. That's what Shaitan promises. May Allah save us from the plots of Shaitan. And one of the plots of Shaitan, my dear brothers and sisters, is al-hasad, envy. Mm-hmm. Why him, not me? Why this man, not me? Why? Allah, why did you choose him? Adam's children, Qabil and Habil, right? Qabil decided to kill his brother Habil. But what was the crime of Habil? The crime of Habil? Just because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his own sadaqah, right? That's what happened now. Because Allah blessed someone, now we have that envy. Al-hasad, envy. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, إِيَّاكُمْ وَالْحَسَد. I warn you from envy. فَإِنَّ الْحَسَد, الْحَسَدَ, huh? يَعْكُلُ الْحَسَنَاتِ كَمَا تَعْكُلُ النَّارِ الْحَقَرِ. Envy, brothers and sisters, it destroys our good deeds. Just like the way the fire eats, destroys the wood. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ. Ask Allah, seek refuge, protection from Allah to protect you from the envious person. Wallahi, whether it's good or bad, when the person envies that hits it, he hits it. He doesn't think. And the envious person sleeps. The one that they envied sleeps in the night, snoring. And the one that envies has sleepless nights with migraine, thinking how to destroy that brother or sister tomorrow. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives. أَمْ يُرِيدُونَ أَنْ يُقْسِمُ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّي. They want to divide, yeah? Distribute the portion, the provision of Allah. Allah said, نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَعِيشَتَهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. It is Allah who has decreed and distributed His provision to each and every one of us in this world. Why envy someone? Ask Allah to give you, to bless you. Call Allah, ask Allah, and pray for your brother or sister who has been blessed by Allah. Because whatever dua you make for your brothers and sisters, the angels, they say, unto you the same. Ameen. I was teaching the sisters and I said, I want all of you to ask yourself right now, how many dua did you make for yourself for the whole week? They said, what do you mean, Sheikh? I said, because when you make dua, good dua, the angels, they say unto you the same. When you make the bad one as well for your brother, they said unto you the same. Don't tell me how many bad ones and good ones did you get this week? Right? Go for the whole week. Someone will not even ask Allah, Jannah praying every day. The dua they ask against someone is more than dua they ask for themselves. Jama, what world are we living in? Very strange world. As Muslims, we should be messengers of peace. We should be carrying peace out there. We should be sources of peace, harmony, tranquility. So, this is what happens. Envy. And that's what removed Shaitan from where he was. Because he envied Adam alayhi salam and Hawa. Because of hasad. Envy. So this is a plot, trick of Shaitan. Don't envy anyone. The only envy that is allowed in the deen is when you envy someone because they are doing good, you want to do like the same good or better than that. Like me, I envy my sheikh. To be honest with you, whenever he needs me, I don't want him to stop. Because he's doing something good. I want to do the same or better, right? That's how we have to envy someone, in a good way. And when you envy someone in a good way, you love them, right? The good envy in the deen attached with what? Love. And the other envy, the hatred, that one attached with what? Hate. You see the opposites? When you envy someone in the deen, in a good way, you pray for them to get more, right? When you envy someone in a bad way, you want to destroy them, to put them down, right? So tell me, are we the one who distributes our portions or Allah? Do we believe in the qada Allah? Wa qada? We believe that it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gives, right? Do we believe? Hey, brothers. Do we believe?
Yes.
Then, if you answer yes, I want you to ask yourself, to assess yourself, to put your own soul into account right now. If you have envied someone because Allah blessed them, then ask yourself right now, why did I do that? Why? You know yourself better than we are. You know what you think. You know how you feel. When you sit there, you know what you're thinking. When you look at your brother, and you look at him, what comes, what plays in here? When you look at your sister, what goes in here? Why? Why then? If we do believe. Because Allah said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا صَالِحًا. Whenever Allah says they believe, and they do good deeds. In other words, they implement their faith. So this is a trick and plot of shaitan. We must abstain from it. And one of the tricks of shaitan, one of the most dangerous one, is the tahrish. That's why I love the ayat the Sheikh recited. Tahrish. Shaitan to come and create fitna amongst brothers and sisters. Allahu Akbar. Brothers and sisters, all over the world, I tell you the truth. Not in this masjid, not in my masjid, not in any masjid, only masjid in London, but masjid all over the world, you find out tahrish is happening amongst the brothers and sisters. A brother is coming here, going that way, we are all in the same masjid. Now the brother is coming this way, because he sees that brother coming this way, he goes that way. Because he doesn't want to greet him. Maybe the stuff is like this, you come, the brother stand here, because he's the only one who stand, you go there, you find the other way to squeeze yourself so you cannot stand close to the brother. Tahrish. And sometimes as well, shaitan will come, something will happen, someone will say a word, probably without even reasoning. And that particular word will just be the source of the tahrish. Allah said, as my sheikh was reciting it, he said, وَاَعْتَسِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold on together. Come together. Unite to the rope of Allah. And that is a deen. The deen. Deen, unite. Allah said, do not divide yourself into groups. What happened? فَتَفْشَلُوا. Look, the Quran. Allah said, فَتَفْشَلُوا. And you will fail. Is that, this is what happened, isn't it? Is that not what happening now? Allah said, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا. Do not divide into groups, sects. By doing so, فَتَفْشَلُوا. Fashion, you will fail, become failures. And when you become failure, what did Allah say? وَتَذْحَبْ رِيحُكُمْ. Your strength will go. You become weak. Weak. And when you become weak, your heart will attach to this dunya. To the dunya. Become weak and attach to the dunya. Looking at your brother, saying, brother, salamu alaikum. But that salam is not from here. And when we say salamu alaikum, wa alaikum salam. Tahrish. It comes and brings fitna amongst you. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it clear about this tahrish. He said, inna shaitan qad ya'is. He said, shaitan has lost hope. He gave up. Look, shaitan gave up. Could you imagine?
He gave up. أن يعبده المصلون في جزيرة العرب. Yeah? The Muslims, the believers, not only جزيرة العرب. The Arabs, Africa, England, Europe, everywhere. The Muslim, Shaitan will not come to you and say to you, brother, bow down to this battle or I don't know. Yes. He gave up. He gave up, I mean. He has given up everything for you. In other words, with related to your ibad, someone to worship an idol. No, he gave up. But the Rasul bring buts, right? Then it means there is something else. He said, "Walakin, but fit tahrish baynahum." But he will bring confusion, misunderstanding amongst them. Fitna. Fitna amongst ourselves. Muslim beating up a Muslim. Muslim slapping a Muslim. Muslim swearing at a Muslim. Muslim cursing a Muslim. Seeing even they will not go even out. They start in the masjid and say, who are you? Come here, I show you. And I see a Muslim saying, Allahu Akbar. They come to the masjid. And he said, wait. Don't worry, it's time for salah. Let's finish salah. Subhanallah. Let's finish salah. Now you finish salah. Can you imagine? You're saying, okay, let's finish salah to go and do munkar. Right? Haram. And one is fasting there in Ramadan, fasting. He said, don't worry. Wait for the time when we break our fast. Tahrish. You see how dangerous Shaitan is? Brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used a word in the Quran. If you contemplate over that word, why did Allah use that word? Me and you, let's be honest, practically, are we brothers? From blood? No, from blood. Are we? No. Why? Huh? It's true. It's true, brother. Don't worry. Because we come from different mothers and fathers. Not the same blood. You're not my brother, I'm not your brother. Except if we go to humanity, we said we come from there. But when we come to our own biological trend, no khalas. I'm not your brother. Because you're not my brother. I can marry your sister, you can marry my sister, right? Yeah. But when it comes to the deen, Allah did not say your friend. He did not say your lover. He used the word innamal mu'minuna. Ikhwa. Go and check. Look at the definition of ikhwa. Check what is ikhwa. Look at the definition of ikhwa in the deen or even ikhwa, brother. Allah used the word, your Muslim brother and sister, they are brothers to you. You are all as believers. He did not say, innama banu Adam. He did not say, indeed, the children of Adam, ikhwa. No. He said, innama al-mu'minuna, ikhwa. The believers, they are brothers and sisters. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Perfect that brotherhood. Perfect that sisterhood. Be a brother. Your brother, they said, you know, back home they have that slogan. They said, your blood is your blood, right? You have something that attached there. It cannot go. It's your blood, brother. It cannot go, right? So the bond in the deen, the brotherhood in the deen, is stronger and better than the brotherhood of the blood. Why? Because the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that. Yeah? Al-akhillaa yawma idhin ba'duhum li ba'din aduun illa al-muttaqin. Allah said, friends, helpers, there will be enemies yawma al-qiyamah except those who fear Allah. Because their own friendship and brotherhood is based on the love of who? Allah. Based on the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This alone, we cannot go. We cannot say anything, talk about anything except this. Where's the brotherhood? Where's the unity? Where's the love we're supposed to have for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Where is it? Amongst all the ummah, we are happy to see our brothers and sisters, they all go down. We are happy to see them humiliated. We are happy to see them chastised here and there. But we are not happy to see them rise up. We are not. Is that iman? لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of you, including myself, will be a true believer until you love for your brother what you love for yourself. So where is it? Where's the love? Where exactly do you love for your brother? What do you love for your brother? What do you love for your sister? Do you have that true love in you? Do you love them for who? Now, because we love them because they are footballers, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah? One is killing himself, doing himself because they beat Man United, right? I know you'll say, no, not Man United. Yeah. People are killing themselves for football. And they see their brother, being humiliated, killed just like that. They sit there. They said, you know what, don't worry, as long as I'm fine, me and my brother, I said, come on here, Akhi. At least support them in a good way. Just dua. Feel it. Islam, we should feel for our brothers and sisters. Don't allow anyone to get hurt, regardless of their faith. I'm saying this. The Rasulullah said, they asked him, they said, Ya Rasulullah, who is the best Muslim? He said, Al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimuna min lisanihi. He said, the Muslim is the one from whose hands the people and the Muslims are safe, and the tongue. They are safe from your hand and your tongue. Be a Muslim. Love one another. Don't fight. Islam is not about fighting. No. Islam is love. Islam is love. The non-Muslims, they see, they look at us, they said, look at the Muslims fighting. Yeah. So if someone wants to come to the deen, what kind of deen is he going to practice then? Because you see, Muslim fighting for what? For something, just maybe his power, maybe for money, maybe for just pride. Ya Jamaa, we are brothers. We are sisters. Let's love one another. Let's not divide into sects. Now, we have one book. We have one Nabi. The Quran and Sunnah. What are we fighting? What do we want? What position do we want? Or do you want? قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُوْتِ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءَ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكِ مِنْ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. Say, oh Allah, the King of all kings, the one who owns the dominion. You give. Yeah, power. You crown whomever you will. Trust me, brothers. If Allah did not decree that I will sit here today, I will not sit here. I never ever thought, or even clicked in my mind, or the mind of my family, that I will be an imam sitting here today preaching. I remember, it reminds me one day, one of my mom's friend, I think she's a pastor too. When I sat, she was looking at me. And then she said, oh, gentleman. I said, yes, auntie. What is it? He said, yeah, the way you look, yeah, you were supposed to be a pastor. I said, yeah, I know. She said, you're right. I said, yeah. But I'm a sheikh. I said, so don't worry. That's what I'm doing. To you, I was supposed to be. But to Allah, I am who I supposed to be. You wish, but Allah wishes. No wishes, but Allah decrees. A wish, he doesn't wish. Decree. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easier for us. So it's time for us to share that love amongst ourselves. It's time for us to walk with one another. It's time for us to cooperate together. It's time for us to support our leaders. It's time for us to support the community. Whatever you do, do it only for the sake of Allah. And do not love anyone except for the sake of Allah. And do not give except for the sake of Allah. Do not prevent except for the sake of Allah. Don't speak except for the sake of Allah. And when you do so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. Do you know what it takes when Allah loves you? Another love for servants. You know what it takes here? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. When He loves you, He will tell Jibreel to love you. He will tell the angels to love you. And He will make the creation on the surface of this earth to love you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will descend that love into their hearts. If all Muslims unite, if all Muslims, you know, ignore the minor mistakes of their brothers and sisters, then we will achieve the best. Then we'll be the best role models to the non-Muslims. Trust me. When they look at you, the love you show them, the way you smile to a non-Muslim, because look, these days, when you see a Muslim, say, ah, let me brother. The face, yeah, Allahu Akbar. I said, it's a thunder. Do you know how the face looks like a thunder? Allahu Akbar. Yeah. Somebody says, smile. Oh, plastic smile. Smile, yeah. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. He said, do not belittle any good deeds that comes your way. The least you can do, ولو أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طريق. He said, the least, meet your brother, approach your sister or brother with a smiley face. Come on, give sadaqah. Some are not even smiling. Smile, brothers! Are you not smiling? Sadaqah! تبسمك على وجه أخي صدقة. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam كان بسام. He always smiled. Keep smiling, يا أخي. Because I love you all for the sake of
Allah.
Allah. We're going to get the adhan now, and then we take two questions and we go. Inshallah.